Welcome. Today we are going to break down how pretty much any producer, whether it's a tiny startup or a giant factory, makes two of the most critical decisions they face: how many people they should hire and just how much stuff they should actually create.
So let's start with a classic dilemma. Imagine you've started a business. Things are going great, but how do you decide when to hire more people and, just as importantly, when to stop? Because hiring just one person too many can be the thing that turns your profits into losses. So where is that sweet spot? Okay, to figure this out, let's step into the shoes of a book publisher. It's a simple example, but it's going to show us everything we need to know. Let's dive in.
All right, so here's our starting point. This table shows us how many total books get produced as we add more workers. But, you know, this doesn't really tell us who to hire, does it? To get to that answer, we've got to understand what each additional worker really brings to the table.
So, yeah, how much is each worker actually worth? We need to translate their output, the number of books they help produce, into cold, hard cash.
First up, we have to look at something called the marginal product of labor, or MPL. Now, don't let the fancy name fool you. It's not about the total number of books, it's simply about how many extra books get made when you hire one more person.
And check this out. The first worker adds a whopping 150 books, but look at the fourth worker. They only add 30. This is a super important idea in economics called diminishing marginal returns. It's a fundamental concept, and you see it everywhere.
Okay, now let's put a price tag on that output. This is where the magic really happens. We're going to calculate the value of the marginal product, or VMPL. The formula here is actually pretty simple. You just take the price of the product, that's P, and multiply it by the worker's marginal product, the MPL. For our publisher, let's say each book sells for $100. And boom, this table illustrates so clearly the value each worker generates. That first worker, they bring in $15,000 in value. The second one brings in $10,000, and so on, right down the line.
And this brings us right to our first golden rule. It's super intuitive. Let's say you pay your workers a wage of $5,000. Well, you should keep hiring as long as the value they create is more than or at least equal to that wage.
So there it is. VMPL must be greater than or equal to W, the wage. That's our first rule for maximizing profit. But there's actually another way to look at this exact same problem.
Right, so instead of looking at the value each worker brings in, let's flip it around and look at the cost of producing each individual book. This is called marginal cost, or MC, and it tells us exactly how much it costs the business to produce just one more book, the very next one off the line. And the formula for this? You just take the wage, that's W, and you divide it by the marginal product of labor, the MPL.
Now, this is really cool. What's so interesting here is that as the marginal product goes down, remember, each worker is adding fewer books, the marginal cost to produce each one of those books goes up. See that relationship?
This leads us straight to our second golden rule. And again, it just makes sense. It's only worth making another book if you can sell it for more than it actually cost you to make it. So price has to be greater than or equal to marginal cost. This is the production side of that whole profit maximization puzzle.
So let's put these two incredibly powerful rules right next to each other and see what we've got. See, one rule focuses on the input, that's the labor. The other rule focuses on the output, that's the product. But here's the kicker. As we're about to see, they both point to the exact same decision.
Okay, moment of truth. Let's apply both of these rules to our book publisher and find the single definitive answer.
Let's look really closely at that fourth worker. Okay, so their VMPL is $3,000, but the wage is $5,000. So the first rule says, nope, don't hire them. Now look at the marginal cost. It's $166.7, but the price of the book is only $100. So the second rule also says, whoa, stop producing. Both rules tell us to stop before we hire worker number four.
So there it is. The optimal number of workers to hire is three. That is the sweet spot. That's how this publisher is going to maximize their profit.
So what's the big idea you should take away from all this? Well, maximizing profit isn't about guesswork or gut feelings. It's about making decisions at the margin, constantly comparing the extra benefit you get against the extra cost you pay. It's that simple and that powerful.
This logic we just walked through is the absolute bedrock of decision-making in competitive industries. But it brings up a fascinating question, which we'll get into next time. How do these rules change when there's no competition at all?
What happens when you're a monopoly?